هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا إنا خلقنا الإنسان من نطفة أمشاج نبتليه فجعلناه سميعا بصيرا هديناه السبيل إما شاكرا وإما كفورا.
Wait, Jesus is what?
يا أهل الكتاب لا تغلوا في دينكم ولا تقولوا على الله إلا الحق. إنما المسيح عيسى بن مريم رسول الله. إنما المسيح عيسى بن مريم رسول الله وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه فآمنوا بالله ورسله ولا تقولوا ثلاثة انتهوا خيرا لكم إنما الله إله واحد سبحانه أن يكون له ولد له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وكفى بالله وكيلا.
I don't wear hijab all the time. I am currently struggling with it.
I can literally not put into words the disgust I have for the Muslims who attack reverts for not being the perfect Muslim. Where is this energy when it comes to actual problems in our communities? What? Domestic violence? No, let me tell this woman. She's going to hell for not wearing the hijab. What? Misogyny and racism in our households? People dying? No, let me tell this woman she's going to hell for having a service dog. Or for having a dog in general. Do you not understand that reverts are 100 times better than us? They reverted to Islam. They genuinely put in the struggle of being a Muslim every single day. We were spoon-fed information from birth. And half of this information, by the way, is just culture mixed with religion, dipped in some misogyny, and sprinkled with some personal bias. Why do you attack people over trivial matters, whether they're born Muslim or they're reverted? I'm making a part 2 on this.
Guys, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created our hearts in such a beautiful and a unique way. It is said that if you love anything with your full heart, then that becomes your master. So whether it's money or whether it's big houses or it's literally your spouse or your children, then that thing becomes your master. Meaning you will do anything for it. You will sacrifice your life for it. You will sacrifice time and money and effort all for that thing that resides in your heart. But now let's think about it. The heart is a creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, correct? Now, that creation has no other ability to hold anything else other than its creator, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you give that part of yourself to anything else other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will only cause you suffering and pain. And it makes so much sense. Think about it. We're always trying to fill our hearts with some worldly, materialistic, external thing, but in reality, it's only Allah who can do that.
Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah.
آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين
Can we shave, trim, wax, or pluck our eyebrows in Islam? Nope. We can, however, get rid of the unibrow if you have one. Or if your eyebrows are really bushy, you can clean up the excess hair. But we cannot shave them because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has cursed the ones who do it. Bye-bye!
Dear Allah, it's been such a hard day, and I know the night will not get any better. But I cannot complain, not even for a single second, because you have kept me alive for a reason. Even if I have died inside, I will come to you, Allah, no matter what. I will always come to you with tears in my eyes, or the happiness in my laughter. I will always thank you. You are the only one who can heal me. Ya Allah, I love you. Sincerely, me.
I know you love him, but it's over, mate. It doesn't matter, put the phone away. It's never easy to walk away. Let him go.
الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم
If you recite this dua in the evening, Allah will appoint 70,000 angels to make dua and istighfar for you till the morning. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم Inshallah, start reciting this in the evening before you go to bed. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Five words that can get you into Jannah. Let's go. You're probably wondering why I even know that in the first place, and it's because I honestly have no other chance. Like, there's no way I'm getting in without it. It's pretty simple, and when you actually say this dua, Jannah will actually ask on your behalf to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enter you into Jannah. It goes, Allahumma inni as'aluka al-Jannah. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward. Say it three times.
والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فلهم أجر غير ممنون فما يكذبك بعد بالدين أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين.
Here's your daily dose of motivation. I want you to think of anyone that you look up to, anyone that you are inspired by, anyone that you consider to be successful, literally anyone that you believe left a lasting imprint on this earth and changed the world for the better. I'm here to remind you that the same God that created those people created you. So what makes you think that you are not destined for greatness? What makes you think that you are incapable of accomplishing anything and everything that you set your mind to? God created you for a reason. You're still here for a reason. Every talent, gift, ability that you have is given to you for a reason. So make sure to use those things that were given to you so that you can do good in this world. Don't let your negative thoughts tell you otherwise. I believe in you. You got this.
Alright, what's up, losers? So, what is a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you? So, the easy answer to this question is, if you feel like a lot of hardships, you're having a lot of tests in your life, and you feel like, you know, it's just getting too much, that's a sign that Allah... You might be thinking, well, I just broke up with my haram girlfriend. Was that a test for me? No, it wasn't. Okay, that's just you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you these tests to make you a better person. For example, let's say you lost a job. The way in which you deal with that situation or you approach that situation is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to you, so that it makes you a better person.
Assalamu alaikum. If you guys want to hear some amazing benefits of reciting Ayat al-Kursi, then keep watching. Okay, the first one, if you recite it before leaving your house, not one angel, not two angels, but 70,000 angels from all sides will protect you. And then when you recite it entering your home, it will prevent any poverty coming in with you. If you recite it after wudu, then you'll be raised 70 times in Allah's rank. And if you recite Ayat al-Kursi before you sleep, then one angel will come, look over you, protect you, make sure you're all good. This one's very well known. If you recite after every fard salat, then there's nothing separating you from paradise except death itself. And remember, this message is sadaqah, so don't forget to share with your friends, with your family, so we can both get rewarded. Assalamu alaikum.
Don't skip this hadith where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to you and me directly. Listen to this hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, O child of Adam, if you were to come to me and ask for me, I would forgive you. O child of Adam, if your sins were to reach the clouds of the sky, I would still forgive all of them. O child of Adam, if you were to come to me with sins as great as the earth, I would come to you with forgiveness just as much. SubhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you, no matter what you do, no matter how many times you do it, no matter how big the sin is, I'm going to keep on forgiving you. Listen to this ayah. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقَنَطُوا مِن رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. O my servant who has transgressed against himself, meaning that when you sin, you don't hurt Allah, you hurt yourself. Do not despair, do not give up in the mercy of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all of your sins. SubhanAllah. Just keep turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Please share.
Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there's not anyone on earth who says, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, except that all his sins will be forgiven, even if they were as much as the foam of the sea.
وَلَا أَوْلَادُكُمْ عَنْ بل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون.
And one of the scholars of hadith say, when you enter your house, your spouse, your righteous wife from this dunya, or the one that Allah will give you in the akhirah, will be there before you. And the first time you see her, you know, once says, for 40 years you'll be stuck like that, like, oi, oi, oi. Beauty out of this world.
I'm gonna show you how great I am. Great I am. Great I am.
This kid's gonna be somebody better than anybody ever knew.
I'm gonna show you how great I am.
ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد.
Every single one of us has troubles in his life. Every single one of us has made mistakes. Every single one of us is a sinner. And every single one of us is hopeful and wishful that when I stand before Allah on the day of resurrection, Allah's gonna turn a blind eye and forgive all my sins. Yet you can't even forgive the person you grew up with for years of your life for one issue. You can't even forgive. And people tell me, brother, but it's my heart, it's my right. Let me tell you bluntly, brother, there is no heart in this world. The only heart you will ever have is when you stand before Allah in front of the real judge in the real court. Then and only then will you ever really get your heart. This world will never, ever, ever do you justice.
Is it haram to skip over religious videos on TikTok? As much as I would love to say yes because I would want you guys to listen to them, it's not haram. But give a couple of seconds and try to listen to those reminders. But as I said again, it's not haram.
This is a video for Muslims that do not pray. Listen up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, لا تقمتوا من رحمة الله. You know, there's still people that on their grave right now, I wish they could be in this world, on earth. But guess what? You have the opportunity, you're here, you can change right now. Just do it. You have a change to your life. This will change your life if you start praying. Trust me.
رب
رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي